Hello everyone, coming to you from Seoul, South Korea, and this is Dr. Baek. Dr. Baek, welcome. It's an honor. It's an honor to be sitting with you.
Yeah, I'm Dr. Baek.
We are sitting at really the Mecca, the center of thyroid ablation.
Yes, exactly.
It's quite amazing.
Yes.
For all the professionals who have come together this event. Mm. And Dr. Baek, I think, is a thyroidectomy patient.
You?
Yes. I think it's so important, radio frequency ablation for the patient, because even 10 years ago in South Korea, there was too many thyroidectomies.
Yes.
And now we have a way to remove a thyroid nodule and save the thyroid.
Exactly.
So by, important.
By RF ablation. RF ablation is a thyroid function preserving treatment. Preserving.
Preserve the thyroid.
Yes.
Why is it important for the patient?
As you know, when we have no thyroid, we should take a drug, thyroid drug, right long, taking drug. And in my opinion, the natural thyroid hormone and the drug may be somewhat different to patient. The quality of thyroid hormone, I mean. You understand?
No doubt about it. Quality of life changes after thyroidectomy.
Maybe.
The body, it feels different.
Maybe.
Yeah.
You can feel.
Feel different. Of course, I feel the body is not the same. Some brain fog. And it just, there's other issues that come with not having a thyroid physically. So it's so important for the patient.
Yes.
What has to happen? Because not everywhere is radio frequency ablation being performed.
Yes.
There's still slow adoption.
Yeah.
What needs to happen for further adoption?
That's very good question. In United States, they understand the value of thyroid ablation, but could not start because it is not covered by insurance. The cost of thyroid RFA is too high, but now in some patients, the insurance covers this procedure. That is important. The insurance issue is totally different in each country. You understand? So the cost should be lower than nowadays to adopt this procedure to every country. You understand?
What is the cost of the treatment in South Korea?
In South Korea, the surgery is cheaper than RF ablation in terms of treatment of benign thyroid nodules. Benign. But in case of recurrent thyroid cancer, RF ablation is covered by insurance, so cheap. So many patients want to do RFA rather than repeat surgery.
Why not do RFA the first time instead of the surgery?
It is not allowed in Korea so far. That is the reason of surgery is first treatment for initially detected thyroid cancer.
Are there exceptions when a patient says, I want
I don't want surgery.
RFA, I don't want surgery.
Yeah. But it is not allowed in Korea so far.
Are you going to change that?
I hope, but I'm not sure when it can be accepted by a majority of doctors and our country.
Well, it's too bad. You know, for myself, without a thyroid, I know my quality of life is not the same as it was when I had a thyroid. What has to happen around the world for adoption to advance more quickly?
Ah, okay, that's a good question. In many countries, they are now publish their opinion. I mean, the guideline, their recommendation. They are now publish. The guidelines says RF ablation can be applied to thyroid cancer. But it is another story. The government allows the treatment for thyroid cancer. It's another story. So as many guidelines publish it, the government can allow this procedure to not only benign, but also primary thyroid cancer.
So one of the obstacles is government. Is there another obstacle with a paradigm shift for doctors? For example, we're hearing from certain countries where RFA is being widely accepted, like Brazil.
Yes.
But then we get contacts through RFA-MD from patients in Mexico, and they're having a hard time locating a doctor to perform RFA. Is there just, what needs to happen for the paradigm shift?
I'm not sure. What makes it difficult in Mexico? I'm not sure. But in Korea, as I introduced, the government allows this procedure, we can do it. For government permit the procedure, we need more strong evidence. I mean the publication articles and opinions from many doctors, that is necessary.
It seems like there's a group of doctors that are early adopters, that are ambassadors, advocates. Granted, you've been in the forefront for many years, but doctors who are now coming to RFA are so passionate. They are ambassadors. I'm thinking of doctors like Christian Garcia from Ecuador and Juan Pablo Dueñas from Colombia. They're so passionate about doing RFA and how it saves thyroid. What do you feel, everybody from ACTA, what would you like other doctors to know about RFA or even patients?
As you know, the doctors attending this program, everybody want to learn this procedure and apply to their patient. But some doctors prefer surgery. Surgery is more perfect than RF ablation. It is true. It is true. Surgical excision is more perfect way to treat the thyroid cancer. It is true. But I mean that there is some window who is proper by treating RF ablation even in thyroid cancer. We can we can establish the patient who is a proper indication for RF ablation.
Who is the best candidate?
It is not so clear, clear yet. So it is our role in the future to establish the proper indication.
You know, Dr. Baek, I feel like a lot of this, it falls on the patient to be their best advocate. I think the patient now is gathering information. They are discovering RFA.
They are
discovering that RFA can be used for malignant in some cases. And they are being their own best advocate. And they are seeking out and searching for a doctor to perform the RFA and save or preserve their thyroid.
Yes. That is why many foreign patients visit our hospital. Yeah.
They are coming from what countries?
Many countries. A lot of countries. From United States, from Asia, from Europe, even Europe.
You know, you walk around the conference here and the technology is amazing to see everything on display here. And it's amazing what's to come. What do you feel are some of the more interesting things to come in the next year or two? What do you see in the future?
In the future, I hope we can establish more clear indications for RF ablation and surgery. We can share our lore for our patient more clear and more proper suggestion for our patient. Some patient from other countries to our center, in my opinion, some of them are not proper for thyroid RF ablation. That means many doctors could not differentiate proper and improper patient. So we need to establish that point.
When a patient comes from the United States, what is the approximate cost if they're paying cash?
Much cheaper than United States in our country, because as you know, the medical cost in United States is so high. That is why they visit our hospital.
One thing we were going to talk about was the training. What do you feel for the people watching, for those listening? What should the doctor know about training?
That's a good question. Over the past three years, because of COVID, we closed our training program. So we have planned to reopen the training program next year with the collaboration of many doctors and many companies.
So how can a doctor find training if they would like to
join? Please follow my SNS. I will post our training program and a very nice and very educational cases in my SNS. Please follow.
So where can they locate? We're going to put the link on the screen. They'll see the link and the information in the description.
Yes. I believe you know my SNS.
That's right. So you'll see that in the description to the episode. They can find the link.
Facebook and the LinkedIn.
That's right. And new papers are being published
every
day.
Of course.
New success stories from around the world.
Yeah.
Dr. Baek, thank you.
Thank you for your visiting our conference.